Hello makers, I recently bought a lot of stuff from China because not long time from now it's getting really expensive to import things from China. So I also bought a 7-inch touch display with a resolution of 800 by 600 with this flat bend cable, and the listing says it's Raspberry Pi compatible. Such a small screen with integrated display driver for around 20 euros, that's amazing. So, let's try connect it and let's see if it was worth the money. I have here a Raspberry Pi 3 and what? This doesn't fit. One moment. Well, it seems I still need a driver board for this. So I'm going to order one and we'll see back in well, about 3 weeks or so. Well, here I am again with my 7-inch touch display, my Raspberry Pi, and now a driver board for the screen, which cost me an additional 10 euros. So let's try to connect it. Okay. On this bend, there's one side with the connections and one blank side. The side with the connections should always point to the driver board. So attach this here. Why isn't it holding in place? Ah. There's a lever. You have to push it down to fix it. Yep. Now I should be able to connect this to the Raspberry Pi with. Okay, this seems the only flat bend cable connector. So let's use HDMI, which I don't have at the moment. Well, I think we'll see us tomorrow again. Now I have small, very short HDMI cable that we can connect to the Raspberry Pi. And I think we need power supply for this board. The listing says it's rated from 5 to 24 volts. There was neither a connector nor a power adapter delivered with it. So I'm using my bench power supply. To avoid any short circuits, I put a cardboard between the display and the driver and switch it over. Let's try. Let's start with 9 volts. That should be enough, and a little more than half an amp. Okay. And now let's turn the Raspberry Pi. And see if it starts. Nothing so far. What seems to be the problem here? Maybe it needs a little more voltage. Well, I figured it out. And this means I told you something wrong. This connector has connection pins on the counter side of the board. So the pins on the flat bend has to point upwards. And now, if we power this board, hey, we can see something. No signal. Let's see if you can change the source here. AV, AV1, HDMI. And here it comes live. Does the touchscreen work? No, but it should be a touchscreen. Well, at least I have got I got something here. Let's check out why the touchscreen isn't working. I come to you back in a moment. So I managed to get Raspberry Pi working. If you use a new installation of Raspbian, it should be easy to configure this display. And let's play a video in full screen. This is full screen? Weird. The videos are quite smooth on the display. It seems the refresh rate is quite good for this small display. Okay, the video is high quality on a low quality computer and a low quality display. This makes this a little harder to watch. I didn't get the touchscreen to work. I searched the internet and didn't find a solution as well. But there's a second ribbon cable taped to the first one. It's a 2-pin cable. This could be a signal line for the touchscreen. There's two solar points in it. And I'm not quite sure how to connect to the Pi. Maybe I need an MCU in between. And then I connected via I2C to the Raspberry Pi pins. Or maybe there's a built-in MCU, so I can directly connect it to the I2C pins. Not sure. If you know how I get this touchscreen working, please put it down in the comments. Then I'll make a follow-up video for this. And the good news. I lowered the voltage to about 5 volts. And it draws a current about half an amp. That means you can power the LCD and the driver board with a standard USB power source. You just have to build your own connector for this. I'm not sure why they use this kind of connect and not a micro or a mini USB in. Well, this project cost me a little more than expected. That's about 20 euros for the screen and about 15 euros for this driver board or 10 euros for this driver board. It's still a little cheaper than the official 7-inch display from Raspberry Pi, but I had to order this display, the driver board, from China and still didn't get the touchscreen to work. If I can find a project where I won't need the touchscreen, I think it's a quite good bargain. Maybe I'll buy a second one for the second driver board and build some project with this. I'll keep you informed. Until then, be creative and bye!